Next, I am taking problem number 20 from the question bank. It goes like this. A hollow steel column has to carry an axial load of 3 meganewton. The load to be taken is 3 meganewton. Right. If external dia of the column is, external dia is 300 millimeter, find the internal dia. If the ultimate stress of steel, ultimate stress is 480 newton per mm square, and the factor of safety is 4. This is the problem, problem number 20 from question bank. Here, this will be, if you want to convert it into newton, this will be 3 into 10 to the power of 6 newton. See, kilo means 10 to the power of 3, 1000. Mega means another 1000, that is 10 to the power of 6. Giga means GN it will come. Then it is 10 to the power of 9, another 1000. So 1000 into 1000 into 1000, that makes it 10 to the power of 9. So mega newton means 10 to the power of 6. Now to explain this, I will draw a rough sketch of this. This is the, let us say, short column. This is the short hollow column. Hollow it is. This is outside diameter. This is inside diameter. Its top view will be like this. This is how its top view will be. Now, he has given the external diameter. It is hollow. If there are two diameters, that means it is hollow. We have to find out this D. He has given what is the load that is applied. It may be either tensile load or this thing. He has given this. Now, allowable stress. First, we will find out the allowable stress will be F ultimate, that is maximum stress, divided by factor of safety. Because factor of safety is the ratio of ultimate stress to working stress. So, this is ultimate stress is how much? 480 divided by 4. This works out to 120 newton per mm square. This is the allowable stress. So, it has to take this much of load. So, what should be the diameter, he is asking. Now, we know F is equal to P by A. So, therefore, what will happen? A will be equal to P by F. This, we know this and this. We don't know this. We have to find out that. So, P by F. P is 3 into 10 to the power of 6 divided by F is 120. If you divide this, I think you will get 3 followed by 6 zeros divided by 120 will give you 25,000 mm square. So much area is necessary. This is the area that we have to have. Now, area of a hollow cylinder will be, hollow section we create is, it will be pi by 4 into capital D square minus small d square. So, 4a by pi will be equal to d square minus d square. Now, what I will do, this small d, this is what I have to find out. This I will take it this side. So, it becomes plus d square. It becomes plus d square. This I will transfer it to the right side. It becomes minus. So, d square is already here. Minus 4a divided by pi. This will give me d square. The square root of that will give me d. So, d will be equal to, small d will be equal to, small d will be equal to square root of d square minus 4a divided by pi. So, make a substitution here. This is 300 square minus 4 into A is 25,000 divided by pi. Subtract these two, then get the square root. Now that will be equal to the inner diameter. So small d will be equal to, take your calculator, 300 square minus 4 into 25,000 divided by pi equals, I got something, 58,000 something. Square root of answer will give me roughly 241.2 mm. This is the inner diameter. They could have asked the thickness, this thickness, then it will be capital D minus small d divided by 2 will give you that thickness if we had asked. He has asked only the diameter, so we stop there. This is a problem. Another problem which I have taken, I have selected because it is something different from what we did earlier. Now let us take one more problem. The next problem is the 24th problem. I have selected the 24th problem. Now this goes like this. 24, problem number 24. Determine the bulk modulus and the lateral contraction delta D if dia is 50 mm, length is 2 meters and change in length extension is 2 millimeter. When Young's modulus or modulus of elasticity is 100 kilonewton per mm square and C is, modulus of rigidity is 40 kilonewton per mm square. Now, a little alteration in units first. We'll make a few little alteration. This is okay, this is in mm. This will be 2000 mm. This will be 100 into 10 to the power of 3 newton per mm square. That is, I have converted this kilonewton into newton there. Similarly, this will be, 40 into 10 to the power of 3 newton per mm square. Now this can also be written as 1 into 10 to the power of 5, 3, 4, 5 zeros. This can be written as 0.4 into 10 to the power of 5 newton per mm square. Newton per mm square. You can write it like that. Now with this data, we have to find out these two quantities. That is, bulk modulus is to be found out and change in dia. Contraction, lateral contraction means diameter wise what is its change. That's what he is asking, and these two we have to find out. Now we'll do it like this. I have given a relationship earlier, that is E is equal to 9kc divided by 3k plus c. This is a relationship which connects Young's modulus, rigidity modulus and bulk modulus, E, C and K. Now, out of these three, we know two, E and C are given. We have to find out K. Now, what I will do is, I'll cross multiply this. I get E into 3K plus C. This is to be done very slowly. This way, if you multiply, it will be 9kc. So, if I open this bracket, 3ke plus ec is equal to 9kc. So, ec will be equal to 9KC minus 3KE. Slowly, I am doing it very, very slowly so that you can understand it. So next, what you can do is, I will take out K as common factor here. If I take out K as common factor, 9C minus 3E will be left here. K is taken out. So EC divided by 9C minus 3E gives me K. This is what I want. I want K. So I have changed that formula. I have changed that relationship so that K is on one side and all other quantities are on the other side. So K is equal to E into C divided by 9C minus 3E. This is what I got. Now, very slowly, if you have any difficulty, you can always clarify it. E is 1 into 10 to the power of 5 into C is 0.4 into 10 to the power of 5 divided by 9 into 0.4 into 10 to the power of 5 minus 3 into 1 into 10 to the power of 5. Now, this will be equal to, this will be equal to 1 you can leave, 1 into 0.4, 1 into 0.4 is 0.4 only, into 10 to the power of 5 into 10 to the power of 5 divided by, here I can take out 10 to the power of 5 as common factor. I am left with 9 into 0.4 is 3.6 minus 3 into 1 is 3. So 1 10 to the power of 5, 1 10 to the power of 5 gets cancelled. I am left with 0.4 into 10 to the power of 5 divided by, this will be 0.6. So it will be 0.6666, like that it will come. You can take it as 0.67 into 10 to the power of 5 Newton per mm square. Now this is the value of bulk modulus. We got bulk modulus. We got this. One more quantity is to be found out, and that is delta D, change in diameter, lateral contraction, decrease in diameter, how much it is going to decrease. Now for that, what I do is I have to get first 1 by m, that is lateral, this Poisson's ratio. You know, we know that E is equal to 2C into 1 plus 1 by M. From here, I can get this. How? E by 2C is equal to, if I send this 2C that side, 1 plus 1 by M. So, E by 2C minus 1, this 1 if I transfer here, it will be 1 by m. So 1 by m will be equal to E divided by 2C. So E is 1 into 10 to the power of 5 divided by, sorry, E minus 2C minus 1, minus 1. So 1 into 10 to the power of 5 divided by 2 into 0.4 into 10 to the power of 5 minus 1. This 10 to the power of 5, this 10 to the power of 5 gets cancelled. So 1 by 0.8 minus 1. 1 divided by 0.8 equals 1.25 minus 1. That will be 0.25. This works out to 0.25. This is Poisson's ratio, 1 by m, Poisson's ratio. Its value will be always less than 1. It will be usually 0.25 to 0.3. So I got this Poisson's ratio. Then linear strain, that is E, is equal to delta L by L. I know both delta L by L, that is change in length by original length. I know delta L is 2 mm divided by 2000. Original length is 2000, that is 2 by 2000, it works out to 1 into 10 to the power of minus 3, 1 into 10 to the power of minus 3, or it can also be written as 0.001. That is, this point is here, it has to be moved 3 digits this side. So it will be 0.001, that is linear strain. Now this Poisson's ratio is nothing but lateral strain by linear strain. So we know Poisson's ratio, we know linear strain, we can get lateral strain. Lateral strain will be equal to 1 by m into e, that is 0.25 into 0.001. This I already have here, into 0.25. That will give me 2.5 into 10 to the power of minus 4, or it is 0.00025. You can write it this way or that way, anyway both are same. So that is the lateral strain. Now once you have lateral strain, you know lateral strain is, lateral strain is change in dia by original dia. We know that. Lateral strain is change in dia divided by original dia if it is a circular rod, circular object. So delta D will be equal to lateral strain into original diameter. Lateral strain is 0.00025. into original dia is 50 mm. So this answer multiplied by 50 will give me 0.0125 mm. This is the change in diameter. So friends, I have done a few problems.